Welcome to the first official walkthrough video for Orchestral 2's new series called Fabric. My name is Cornelius and I'll be guiding you through new installments. Before we get into it, let's talk about Fabric for a second. Fabric is a series where we discover rougher, more electronic and more experimental sounds. Occasionally, we'll be working together with artists that are not necessarily tied to the film or the classical music genre, as we believe music and sound benefit from keeping an open mind and doing things differently. Let's talk about the first collection called Transit. It was made from field recordings of rail traffic in Berlin. Now, if you downloaded it under My Licenses, you will find it in the Library tab. If we click Browse, you will have three categories: tonal, atonal, and percussive. Let's explore the tonal section first. So let's start off with the bass section. I'm going to load them all in by double-clicking, and then I'll pick the second one called Diesel Power. Here's what it sounds like. So it's really dark and distorted. Let's check out the carburetor next. Last but not least, let's listen to the one called Combustion Chamber, which is more of a drone sound. So here's what it sounds like. The next category I'm going to show you is called Pads. First one's called Engine Start. Nice evolving sound. Next up, we have the Stoker. Check out the spark arrestor next. Next off, we'll check out the analog synthesizer section. I've got the supercapacitor loaded, it's the short version of it, and it sounds like this. So here's a little arpeggiated sequence. And what you just heard was a second oscillator mapped to the second dynamic layer. You can turn it off by clicking the second dynamic layer. Now another fun thing with this is to turn on the cutoff filter and adjust the filter range, go to the main settings and change this to velocity. So this way you have a velocity sensitive filter. It's It's also very fun to play around if you have an arpeggiator going, as it will drastically change the rhythm of your sequence the way you press the key. A lot of fun to play around with. Next off, we will check out the ultracapacitor patch. It follows the same principle, but instead of only one oscillator, we have two mapped to the second dynamic layer, and they're little detuned and panned to left and right. So what you get is a really fat sound. Next off, we have the atonal section. We have a couple of noise patches in here. I'll show you a few. That one's called Passage. Another one I'd like to show you is called Departure. Again, great for adding atmosphere and anything that needs a little noise layer on top. We also have some impact sounds in here. First I want to show you is called Platform. So this has a lot of power and it has some depth and some industrial sound to it. Same goes for Viaduct. Last but not least, let's check out the percussive section. In there you will find 5 construction kits as well as multiple mapping options. But let's check out the kits first. This one's called Shunter. So with every kit, you get 2 kick drums, 2 snare drums, 3 hi-hats, and a set of percussion. Now let's check out another one. This one's called Commuter. Now checking out some of the mapping options, first of all we have the multi-patch. It is great if you want to audition sounds, so say you have programmed a rhythm and you want to check out what does it sound with another kick drum. We'll have them all layered out across the keyboard, same goes for snares of course, and the hi-hats. Percussion also there, and you can easily interchange in between and audition sounds to see what fits the production best. We also have a set of single instruments, so you can choose if you need kick drums, snare drums, hi-hats or percussion. They are mapped out across the keyboard, same as the multi-patch, so you can quickly exchange and audition sounds. The last category of transit is called percussive tools. In there you will find interesting percussive instruments such as the anvil piano. So in the upper register, to me it sounds like a strange piano, but down below it has this really melancholic, eerie sound to it. This concludes our walkthrough video for Transit. a library that lets you add a raw industrial touch to your music. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you for the next one.